Google has made an exciting announcement by making Gemini Code Assist now free for everyone. So for those who don't know, what is Gemini Code Assist? This is basically a Visual Studio Code extension, quite similar to Microsoft's Copilot. So we can just add this in our Visual Studio Code extension and it will help us in coding. Exact same way how Copilot does. You can directly ask any questions from your code and it will give us the response and we can make modifications. And the insane thing about this Google Code Assist is that the number of code completions that it's offering. For example, usually they have given 2000 code completion, but they are offering around 180,000 code completions per month. So code completion is nothing but you asking prompts. That's it. So I'm not even sure if people will be using all these, but that's insane. And this particular assist is not only available for Visual Studio Code, but it's also available for most of the JetBrain IDEs like IntelliJ, and they are saying it's available in Android Studio also. So now let's see how we can use this. And at the moment, I'm just having here a normal React app, a fresh React project in my Visual Studio Code. So now we will be having this extensions over here. Select it and just search for Google Code. And you'll be having this Gemini Code Assist, or you can just search Gemini Code Assist also. So currently it's having 245,000 downloads. Just click on install and trust. And that's it. We can just now close this and again go to my projects folder. And now to the left below extensions, we are having this Gemini Code Assist icon. Just click here. And if you want to know the key features, you can just read it through, okay, what it basically does. And the model that they are using over here is a fine-tuned version of Gemini 2.0. So as you can see here, we fine-tuned the Gemini 2.0 model for developers for analyzing and validating a lot of real-world coding use case. So this is the model that they have deployed over here. So it's the latest model. And you need to sign in with your Google account. So I'll just click here and click on open. And once you sign in, you'll be getting this interface. Here we can ask Gemini any questions. And apart from this side icon, we are also having another icon to the top near the run button. We are having this smart actions. So if you click here, we are getting basically four options. So first, let's make use of this left side, you know, chat interface. So first, let me just go here. And as you can see, it says us to ask Gemini or type at. So I'll just type the at symbol. And basically, this will display all the files that are present in my project. So I'll just go to this particular file and I will just ask it to explain this code. So as you can see here, it has given a basic description and also has displayed the code over here and literally explained each and every line of the code. So, and it's also given us the sources from which where it has, you know, got this answer from. So if you didn't have this tool or something, what would have done is basically like copied the code, went to ChatGPT or Gemini or some other AI chat and would have asked it to explain. So now it's just within your editor itself. So as you can see, this Gemini Code Assistant is literally present in the left pane. So if I want to view the files, I have to click this and open my files. But now the Code Assistant can't be seen. So what you can do is you can just go here and basically you can just drag this and put it over here like this. So now we are having the files towards the left. We can open any file of our choice. And we're also having the Gemini chat towards the right. And to again open this to the top, you'll be having this toggle secondary sidebar. You can just open this. If you close it, you can just open it this way. And if you click this, it basically creates your new chat. So now let's see how we can add a particular feature to our existing code. So I'm just having here a normal React.js default project, right? Let's see how we can add a login screen to this project. So I'll just go to here and ask a prompt. And this time I'm not going to put a at and specifically point any file. I will lead that to Gemini. So it is going to basically scan my entire files in my project and then determine which files it needs to make changes for this login screen. So this is my prompt. Give me code for login screen with CSS. That's it. And let me just run. So it has given the code. First one is loginscreen.js, next loginscreen.css, and it has given the explanation. And also here it has given me to put this code in index.js or app.js. So there are multiple ways how you can integrate this code inside your existing code. For example, first feature is copy to clipboard. So this copies the entire code and you can just go and paste it to your desired file. Next one is insert in current file. So as you can see, I'm having my index.js file opened. So if I hover over it, I'm having an option to just insert this particular code into this file. But I don't want this to be inserted in index.js because this is a new file. Next one is diff with open file. So if I click here, this basically shows the difference of the code between index.js, which is the current file that I'm having opened, along with this new code. I also don't want that to happen. And final one is open in a file. I want this, so I'll just click here. And this basically creates as an untitled file. But I'm not recommending you to do this way. The simplest way how you can do is just go to the folder where you want to have this piece of code of new file. You can just copy the file name alone like this, go here, new file, and put the file name over here and create this file. And now what you can do is just select insert in current file, click here, and that's it. This file will be getting inserted over here, and I'm getting some warnings over here like this yellow lines. So it says use code with cautions, suggested code may be subject to licenses. You can just go and click on this quick fix and just click on ignore. So that basically will remove us this yellow color line, okay, like this. Yeah, now all the yellow color line has gone and you're having this code for you itself. And now exact same thing applies for this loginscreen.css. Just create a new file and click on this insert into current file, okay. And finally we are having the changes made in index.js. So I've just closed here, and this is the index.js file currently. So what you can do is you can just click on diff with open file. So we will be getting an interface like this, which basically shows the code that has been excluded and the code that has been added over here. And in case if you like the code that it has generated, you can just click on this accept at the top. So now as you can see here, this little code has been put over here. And let me just now save it, and it has been compiled successfully, and this is the login screen that I get. That's not bad. We literally got this in like few seconds. And now let's see how we can make in-file changes. For example, let's say I'm not satisfied with this color, okay, not satisfied with this background color or something, and go here and put a at and just pin that file. I'll just go with login. We're getting this login screen.css. Just go and ask, can you make changes to the color and make it more stylish, something like this. So it has given us the response. And in case if you want to directly copy this, you can just, you know, delete the entire content and you can just put insert in current file. This will also do the work. Or in case if you really want to see the differences, you're having this diff with open file. So this basically shows us the differences, okay. And in case if you don't want a particular difference, let's say I don't want this particular code to be added, you can just click on this arrow mark. So this basically like removes that difference, okay. So it can also be done, but if you are satisfied with all the changes, you can just click on accept. That's it. And now let's see what changes it has done. So that looks pretty amazing. I can see the gradient background, and there has been a gradient over here also. So this is another way how you can correct, you know, an existing code if you don't like it. And next, as you saw earlier, we're having this smart actions, right? And you can try to generate new code, fix something, and generate unit test. So if I select this, like, okay, it has generated unit test for the login screen. So yeah, and it has also given us how we can run this test cases. So you can just create a new file like this, loginscreen.test.js, install the necessary testing library, and you can even like start writing test cases. So that's the video, guys. Check it out and do let me know how it works for you. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.